Were you ready to become a father?
Bumalik ako sa showbiz, pero...
Were you ever lost?
Siyempre, you wanna take your audience with you, di ba?
Yun ang frustration mo. As an artist talaga. Everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Eto na naman tayo. First of all, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for all the support you have given this channel. This is your channel. And also, I would like to thank you for the great feedback that you gave us with our episode on sisterhood with Alice and Small. Today, we have a special feature, part 1 and part 2 of the most enigmatic, multi-awarded, the best actor of his generation, John Lloyd Cruz. Nasa na nga ba si John Lloyd all these years? At ano nga ba ang pumasok sa isip niya? Guys, welcome, John Lloyd Cruz. Hello, JL. Do I call you John or JL?
Kahit anong kahit.
What do your friends call you?
My dearest friends call me Idan.
Idan? Where did that come from?
My cousin used to call me Ijan. Parang halimbawa, Igoy from Rodrigo.
Yeah.
Ibon from Ribonet.
Ang galing.
Kami yung magkakadikit halos yung edad. So, nagkaroon ng pattern.
You know what? You were last year 2015. It's now 2021. So it means I haven't seen you in 6 years, right?
Ano bang nauna? Yung when I bumped into you in New York or?
Ang ganda ng question, New York.
Nauna yun.
Nauna yung New York. Oh, ang galing ng memory. So we bumped into each other in New York and we had a few drinks. And yes, okay, we drank. And then 2015, we were here together again, celebrating. So technically 6 years, but with work, people say after a 4-year hiatus, JL is back.
Oh.
How do you feel when people say that? Bumalik na si JL.
Merong isa na nagsabi na dinagdagan niya ng bumalik na sa showbiz. Oo nga naman, bumalik ako sa showbiz. Pero hindi ako umalis sa paggawa ng sine. Hindi ako umalis sa harap ng camera kasi kahit naman tumigil ako noon with my usual work in showbiz or in films and TV, nagtuloy pa rin naman ako, but much, much smaller production.
And you suddenly decided to go a different direction. What happened?
Medyo crowded dun sa isang daan eh. But that's really true. Diba? Parang when it gets crowded, sa trabaho namin, napaka-vital nung, teka lang, are you making the right decisions? Are you making the right choices? Are you behaving
the way they want to?
Or the way you want to?
Okay, kasi okay.
Talagang binabago tayo yung...
industriya.
In many ways na pwede mong ma-imagine. Akala mo parang you had it all figured out. Pero bigla kang may mangyayari sa'yo na parang... And then you realize parang, ah, hindi na ako yan ah. Teka lang, take a step back. Yung pag-step back ko, medyo lumayo lang.
What got you tired?
I guess I got tired of fighting for the content that I want to see on more commercial platforms. We owe it to our audiences. We're growing as performers. Siyempre, you wanna take your audience with you, di ba?
And is that hard?
Yun nga. So, until such time na parang may nagbe-build up na resistance, and somehow, nagkakaroon ka ng idea or concept kung ano yung what you feel strongly about.
But was it burnout too?
It's better to burn out though than to fade away.
That's a good one. Pero really, pagod ba?
Pwede siyang yun, nandun din siya nakapaloob. But ang totoo is, I was evolving, I guess. And it was too complex for me to understand or comprehend. And calling it burnout would somehow, I would feel parang nare-reduce. Kasi it was a combination of so many issues. Eh. Maraming ano, unresolved questions, discontinued dialogue.
With who?
With certain creators. With yung mga nakaupo sa company.
Mm-mm.
I guess, hindi lang yun na pag-uusapan. Hindi Uh-oh. Lang siya nakikita as an angle.
So there's something about you that reminds me of Robert Downey Jr. And his generation was the most promising. And then he got into the dark side, no? And he disappeared for a while and came back a reformed guy. You know, he was lost at one point. Oh, I wanna ask you, were you ever lost?
Oo naman. I guess, ano lang siya eh. Parang, byproduct lang siya ng choices ko eh.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I was meant to be lost, I guess. I was in search of...
something. So you already know what you're in search of?
Ay, nako. It's very disappointing what I found. Wala pala. Sabi ni Brian Ferry, more than this, nothing daw.
Normal people never earn the way really famous people do. So they may be listening and saying, grabe naman si John Lloyd. He had everything, good looks, the women, fame, money. What was he looking for?
Lahat tayo may kanya-kanyang motivation and journey. And kung ano man yung hinahanap natin. Hindi ko talaga matanggal sa akin yung pag kaya natin to i-correct eh. Meron tayong chance. Kasi kung sisimulan natin sa wala na tayong pag-uusapan or sarado ka agad, then para na rin natin tinatanggap na ito na yun.
Oo. Yun ang frustration mo. As an artist talaga. Oo.
Hanggang ngayon ba? Sorry.
Parang eh. Damako eh.
Ang bilis ng panahon, di ba? Magpo-40 ako ngayon. And kaya rin siguro parang nagkaroon ako ng gana na to open up again. Just to continue the dialogue. Mas walang mangyayari kung mamumundok ka.
So, totoo to ha? Si John Lloyd na mundok. Fair?
I'm building a house. Mundok.
People think one of the reasons that you left is you fell in love and wanted to start a family, frankly.
Tingin ko, yung going back to mas grounded, diba?
Mas simple.
Mas simple, diba? Parang, I think, natural lang siya na establishing a desire to have a family. Tingin ko, for someone who got parang defeated in a bout, like boxing, diba? Parang normal lang talaga na bumalik sa ganung klase ng choices and lifestyle. But that's not the entire reason bakit ako tumigil.
Umalis.
Alam mo, Karen, totoo yung pag hindi mo nagagawa yung gusto mo, nagkakaroon ka ng imbalance. Hindi naman sa naghahanap ako ng kung anong madali, pero hindi ko sila makonvince, hindi ko nagawa.
Mm-mm. People often talked about your talent alongside with John Lloyd's demons. The dark side of John Lloyd. Drugs, drink, the artist's life. How would you describe that when you hear it?
Expected. Hindi nila kasalanan na ganun yung pananaw nila about certain struggles of like real struggles
of
human beings, no? Why people resort to substance. Mostly, parang you try to pasok dito, labas dito, kasi hindi naman nila alam eh. And hindi mo sila pwedeng condemn or sisihin sa isang bagay na limited yung kanilang pangunawa.
Mm-hmm.
It's unfortunate and sad, pero kasi umaabot siya on the level of ano eh, kamag-anak, diba? Kaibigan, na kailangan mo intindihan, unawain, dahil iba-iba kayo ng pananaw sa buhay, iba-iba kayo ng values. And kung ano yung totoo sa'yo, maaaring hindi totoo sa kanila, ganun talaga.
Mm-hmm. Ano yung naging buhay mo sa El Nido? Yung totoo?
Ang totoo, Karen, hindi pa ako nakatira sa El Nido. When I quit my contract with ABS-CBN, napansin ko na pabalik-balik ako sa El Nido. Hanggang sa nag-decide na akong, sige nga, kung meron ditong makikita na pwedeng tirahan, titira ako dito. Pero wala pa akong bahay doon.
Mm-hmm.
Nakatira ako sa mga kaibigan.
Uh-oh.
Part of my, ano, malaking parte ng aking hiatus nandoon.
Oo. But what did you do when you were there?
A lot of soul searching.
And what did you find?
Wala pala akong soul.
What did you do during that period of soul searching?
I wanted to reconnect with nature. That's one. I wanted to listen again to nature.
Ganda.
Dun sa El Nido, yung binibigay niya sa'yo, hangin pa lang ha. Grabe na. I mean, sobra-sobra na. I mean, mararamdaman mo siya sa paghinga mo eh. And then the food you eat. Para ka talaga yung nire-rehabilitate.
And what was the joy of the simple life?
Sa maraming tao kasi, yung connotation ng El Nido is luxurious eh. No? But kung magkaroon kayo ng opportunity gaya ng nabigay sa akin, yung mga tao doon are far more beautiful. Kasi sa pakiramdam ko, Karen, parang they embraced me. Inuunawa ka nila, tinatanggap ka nila.
And you felt free. I would say that's so liberating.
Sobra.
Not to be judged.
Naglalakad ako doon na kayapak. Kaya iba yung nagawa sa akin ng El Nido. And I will always be sentimental about Clinton.
Were you ready to become a father?
Hindi. Hindi. Tingin ko isang bagay siya na akala mo ready ka. because you wanted it. Wow, you're so dumb. We like to believe that we're in control. We like that idea na, de, it's my plan. Inlano ko yan. It took me a while na para matanggap na akala mo binusto mo, akala mo pinlano mo. But in reality, especially ngayon after 3 taon, iba eh. And it won't be as humbling kung talaga naplano mo. Mm-hmm. Paano mo naplano yung ganang bagay? Kasi it's beyond words, like describing how being a father, and especially nung lumabas siya, and there's no way na meron tao na naplano yung ganun ka weird and ganun ka radical na bagay na that's a life. Mm. Buhay yung lumabas because of your responsibility.
And was it the responsibility that sort of got you scared?
Hindi, I didn't get scared at all. I was scared to admit na parang, wait, medyo, it's a little bit too much than what I expected. Pero, yun yata yun eh. I think that's the whole essence of it.
Describe your son. Describe how you feel about being a father to Elias.
Probably the most fascinating thing in my life right now. What I'm learning from him, what I'm learning about him. Kaling eh. Maging ano ka, you'll submit to it.
How would you describe your childhood?
I grew up in a household. Yung lola ko kasi, ano, may lahing Spanyol. So very strict. Ah. Very strict sa parents ko. So somehow, naging strict din yung parents ko sa akin.
Is that why rebelde ka ba?
Hindi naman. Not that kind of strict. Yung mga typical lang sa mga Pinoy households na, oh, bago mag-tumunog yung kampana, di ba, for Angelus, dapat nasa bahay ka na.
Wow.
Yung tatay ko, mas malala yung pinagdaanan dahil nung nalilate siya sa pag-uwi para sa Angelus, lumuluhod pa siya sa munggo.
Oh, wow!
Oo, inabutan pa niya yun.
And ikaw?
Ako hindi na.
Do you wanna be like your father?
As a father, ako, simple lang, I guess. I want to lead without imposing. Ito lang ako on the side. Like, I'm not gonna dictate on you. If anything, yun yung gusto kong mahon niya eh, na I want him to think for himself. Gusto ko lang malaman niya na, kasi parang napansin ko sa nung tumatanda na ako, parang syempre nagiging sinikan na tayo yung Jaylee about life. Parang we tend to forget yung mga early days natin on this earth na parang you were such a blessing. Diba? Somehow it fades away eh.
You're too young to be cynical. You're 38, I'm 50.
Oo, it's my biological age, pero somehow,
oh my God. Mamatch, eh.
Yun lang, parang gusto ko lang makita niya and hindi mawala sa kanya na yung timing niya sa buhay ko napakaganda.
But you are an active father.
Not as much as I want to. I'm sharing him with the mother and syempre, mas nagsispend time yung dalawa.
I'm curious only if you want to answer, no? You've been through several relationships in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think, honestly speaking, you've found true love or the one for you? Even if your heart has been broken, eh? Were you ever together with Bea? Like, did you date?
Allah.
It's either a yes or a no.
I know. Sa totoo lang.
And that was part one of our interview with JL. Una-una, JL, thank you so much for trusting me with this interview and for being my first guest on my podcast. And JL talked about parenting. Lahat tayo may challenges when it comes to parenting. Don't forget, if you're challenged as well, we have a Father in Heaven, and I would like to leave you with this verse. Psalm 103:13. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. We have a perfect father, and don't forget to call him. So I'll see you next week, part two of our JL episode. And don't forget to watch, like, and subscribe.